Hachette Audio presents The Little Book of Life Skills. Deal with dinner, manage your email, make a graceful exit, and 152 other expert tricks. Written by Erin Zammett Ruddy. Read by Caroline Slaughter. To my parents, John and Cindy Zammett, for teaching me so many important life skills, but not enough to preclude me from needing to write this book. Introduction. As a writer for major lifestyle magazines for the last 20 years, my job has been to get experts' advice on everything from making a meeting run smoothly to cooking a perfect burger. From asking for a raise to asking for space to asking a neighbor to take down his Christmas lights come March. All of that is in the book, by the way, except the Christmas lights thing. Honestly, you should just move because that one's really tricky. I love talking to people who really know their stuff, regardless of what that stuff is. Office organization? Yes. Lawn maintenance? Sure. The perfect blowout? 100%. And I know how to deliver that stuff to readers in a way that makes it applicable to their lives. Because a highbrow expert isn't always in touch with those of us who don't own cheesecloth or, a mop. I can always relate to the reader because I am the reader. Yes, even on the stories about, say, decanting your entire pantry into beautifully labeled glass jars. Honestly, am I ever going to do that? Unlikely. Do I want to read about it? Hell yes. So, why did I set out to write this particular book? Because I need this particular book. My father, a former air traffic controller, has been all about order and mental checklists and a little something he likes to call doing things the right way the first time, long before it was all trending. When I was growing up, every spring my sisters and I had to help him dry and fold the pool cover once the pool was open for the season. This was a long, methodical ordeal that had 18 steps and inevitable fire drills. Quick, get it off the lawn, it's burning the beep grass! Then one of us would loudly lament why we couldn't just roll the thing up and call it a day. We'd be answered with a glare. And every fall, as we'd pull the pristine, moldless cover back out of the shed, my father would beam with pride and say something about why we don't half-ass things. The man is efficient, he is organized, and he really does do most things exceptionally well. He also hasn't seen the inside of a control tower since the 1980s, but still approaches every task as if the fate of an entire plane of people rests in the balance. Needless to say, things can get intense when he's involved. But boy, is he a good person to call when you need help making a decision. Me. Every day. I wish I could say his methods all rubbed off on me and I grew up living my best life, surrounded by hospital corners and checked off to-do lists and keys that never got lost. I did not. I got very little of my father's affinity for precision and none of my mother's near professional laundry skills. If I may play psychologist for a moment, I'd say it's because when you have a parent constantly second-guessing the way you're doing seemingly inconsequential things, is that how you're going to cut that bagel? You can't pack your suitcase that way. You really take exit 42 off the expressway, Erin? That red light is a minute and 45 seconds. I've timed it. You sort of give up on striving for the right way and settle for whatever. I'm still getting it done, aren't I? Of course, now I'm 42 and often catch myself mid-task, emptying a dishwasher, decrumbing a counter, arguing with my husband for leaving so many crumbs on the counter, thinking, ugh, there must be a better way to do this. And there is. Like so many of you, just guessing here, I'm craving more efficiency and less stress in my day-to-day routine, a need that's risen steadily as life has gotten more complicated. I mean, there was a time when taking 45 minutes to zigzag my way through the grocery store like a drunken baby, chomping on a bag of barbecue baked Lay's, obviously, and forgetting two of the seven things I ran in for was a perfectly reasonable way to spend my time. That is no longer the case, for a million reasons, but the biggest is probably this. I now have three children, and if you're not staying efficient with kids in your house, you will get swallowed whole by a pile of laundry faster than you can say, if you brushed your teeth, why isn't your toothbrush wet? Or so I've been told. The fact is, there's a particular order in which everything we do in a day should be done. A best practice that will yield maximum results with minimal frazzle. There are also important tricks and tips for taking better care of our hearts and minds. Things I didn't even know were life skills when I went off to college. I also thought fabric softener was detergent, so there's that. But so many of us, just plow through our busy lives without paying attention to how we're getting from one task to the next. This book is not going to make you feel bad about the way you've been doing things, though. Nor is it going to tell you that what you've been doing your whole life is completely wrong, because it's probably not. But there's a good chance it's not the most efficient, effective way to do things either. But wait, can't you just Google the right way to do anything? Of course you can. I certainly have. Type in how to iron a shirt and you'll get 1.2 million results. That is not an exaggeration. I just typed it in and that's what came back. Which is precisely why this book is needed. Who has time to sift through all that often conflicting content and decide what to trust? Do you really need to watch a 7-minute YouTube tutorial on ironing? And what if, oh look, celebrities without makeup? And now you're in a wormhole of Kim Kardashian's Instagram comments. Hey, it happens to the best of us, but weren't you trying to be more efficient here? Newsflash, looking for advice on the internet can be an overwhelming time suck, and that's not including the 15 ads you're now going to get for new irons. So, I went straight to the experts, the best of the best in their fields, to walk through the basic steps for doing things better, things that have always tripped me up. Keeping a houseplant alive, pumping gas. Where I grew up, it was illegal to pump your own, so don't make fun. Introducing two people over email. Why does it always seem awkward? And the mental and emotional stuff we should all have in our repertoire. Talking kindly to ourselves. Taking a calming breath. Saying hi to someone on a train without having to sit next to them. Every entry in the book is chock full of faster, smarter, more streamlined ways to approach the day's to-dos. The reward? More time, less frustration, and the simple pleasure of a job well done. Yes, there is a sense of joy and, okay, Dad, pride that comes from doing something right, even if that something is as simple as emptying the dishwasher or storing a pool cover properly. It's not about rushing through the mundane tasks so you can get to your real life or Netflix queue faster. It's about slowing down and doing the little things right. Because real life is going to the grocery store and writing emails and sitting at a four-way stop sign wondering, who's going to go first? With more than 150 how-tos in the book, written in easy, actionable steps we can all implement, you'll be able to approach every task with more confidence and carry that calm, can-do attitude throughout your day. You'll accomplish more and curse less, and you won't have to call your mom every time you spill something on your silk shirt. Who wouldn't want to infuse their days with wins like that? And some of this stuff is downright genius. Not to overstate it, but the day I learned the quick way to tell which side of the car the gas tank is on was a really big day for me. See chapter 2 for that mind blower. For this book, I've chosen to focus on the basic life skills most of us could use in an average week. Because what's the sense in learning how to paint a bathroom or host Thanksgiving if you don't first know the best way to make your bed? These are the tasks that can make the biggest difference with the smallest adjustments, the things that we do over and over and over again, but rarely stop to ask, wait, am I doing this right? Perhaps some of the daily chores we realized we could use a refresher on after being stuck at home for months. Just me? I've organized the chapters in the order in which you might need these abilities on any given day. From getting up, getting ready, and getting out the door with minimum hassle, to having a productive, satisfying workday, and figuring out what the heck to order for lunch, to advice on getting through all your housework and yard work pain-free, preparing dinner, and getting a good night's sleep. There are also chapters focused on being your best self in your head and your heart, as well as in your relationships with others. Yes, how to argue productively is a life skill. Oh, and you know how a food blogger lures you to click with the promise of the greatest lemon tart recipe ever? And then there's a 1,200-word essay about her great aunt's lemon farm and the limoncello she drank during her gap year in Tuscany? And you're like, but where's the beep? cheap recipe. The little book of life skills jumps to the recipe for all of it. No backstories or lengthy explanations, no need to skim until the juicy parts. Just the thing, the order in which to do the thing, and the many fist pumps that will inevitably follow when you master that thing. I promise not to judge the way you listen to an audiobook about the right way to do things, as long as you promise not to tell my dad, I still totally take exit 42. Every damn time. Chapter 1. Wake up and get ready for the day.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.